Are you struggling to choose between Drizzle and Prisma? Both these libraries enable data access and migrations, but which one is the right one for you and for your code? Today's video will help you understand what the difference is between Prisma and Drizzle, what their relative strengths and weaknesses are, and help you decide which one is the best fit for you and for your project. And to do so, we're first going to explore what an ORM is, how Drizzle and Prisma's approach to building ORMs differs, and which might be the best fit for you. But first, Drizzle and Prisma are both ORMs, but what does that mean? ORM stands for Object Relational Mapping. I've explained the concept in a previous video if you want to explore that in greater depth, but in short, the name says it all. ORMs translate data between two structurally different formats, between relational databases where data is stored in rows, which are flat, and your code, where in general, data is stored in objects, which are nested. ORM libraries converts data one way and back between database schemas and object-oriented programming. This translator abstracts away the mechanics of updating, retrieving, deleting, and managing data from the database, allowing you to focus on your business logic. Their goal, in short, is to improve the developer experience, or DX. Now, there's a saying in French, traduire, c'est trahir. To translate is to betray. Shortly put, something is necessarily lost in translation. Translation exists in a spectrum. Depending on how close you want to be to the words in the source material or the meaning they imply in the target language. A spectrum between literal and idiomatic. For example, there's a French expression, faire d'une pierre deux coups. If you were to translate it literally, it would be to hit twice with one stone. But a more idiomatic expression in English is to kill two birds with one stone. From our perspectives as developers, the source is the database and the target is our application code. Both Drizzle and Prisma simplify how your application interacts with the database. Both translate data from one side to the other, but they use a different translation strategy. Let's start with Drizzle. Drizzle's website states that if you know SQL, you know Drizzle. We embrace SQL and built Drizzle to be SQL-like at its core, so you can have zero to none learning curve and access the full power of SQL. Let's reframe that. On the literal versus idiomatic spectrum, Drizzle is on the literal side. Drizzle adds a TypeScript layer over SQL. Drizzle allows you to write SQL queries using TypeScript. If you want to precisely understand the SQL being run on your database, if you're fluent in SQL, Drizzle might well be for you. Drizzle gives you a high level of control on the SQL being produced. It gives you clarity. It also means that Drizzle is only suitable for SQL databases. Prisma, on the other hand, aims to abstract away the details of the underlying database. It introduces a domain-specific language, or DSL. Prisma is firmly on the idiomatic side of the spectrum. The DSL is less verbose than the underlying SQL. This means there's magic going on behind the scenes. You might have trouble knowing exactly what the generated request is. However, unlike Drizzle, Prisma's approach means it can support NoSQL databases, namely one of my favorites, MongoDB. Prisma and Drizzle's different strategies mean they offer different strengths and weaknesses. It also means that depending on who you are or what you're building, you might be better suited to one or the other. Let's take a closer look. The question perhaps is, how much do you care exactly what's going on in your database? Or to phrase things differently, does your application's success depend on database performance or on development velocity and iteration speed? For example, Prisma means that you can ignore the finer details of SQL and focus on writing business logic code. It favors developer experience and productivity. It's a great tool to help you get your project off the ground fast. However, Prisma means you need to learn the domain-specific language, although it's worth noting there is a VS Code extension to help you there. The DSL means fine-tuning the underlying SQL requests is more complicated. This makes database performance issues difficult to debug. Now, a quick aside here. Prisma does allow you to write raw SQL queries, but at the cost of the type safety that the DSL and Drizzle provide natively. Conversely, Drizzle allows you to use your existing SQL skills to fine-tune the SQL requests being sent to the database. Drizzle enables type-safe SQL requests. This makes it great for scaling database-intensive applications. You use vanilla TypeScript. There's no need to learn a new DSL. However, Drizzle will be more work getting the application off the ground in the first place. It requires more SQL skills and knowledge. It's limited to SQL databases. Now, is there anything else to say when comparing Prisma and Drizzle? Well, Prisma is also a more mature solution with a richer ecosystem and more tools. Drizzle is lighter, it has zero dependencies, which makes it suitable for running on the edge or in serverless environments. Now, Prisma or Drizzle, which should you choose? Well, are you looking to build a quick prototype that you need to get fast to market, and where the value that the application provides is in the user experience more than in how fast the database can be accessed? Or is your SQL skill set light? If this is you, Prisma is probably for you. Conversely, is database performance important to your application? Are you looking to scale a database-intensive application and to capitalize on your SQL expertise? If that's the case, Drizzle is probably for you. Now, let me know in the comments which solution resonates with you the most and why. And also, let me know if you'd be interested in learning more about SQL. And in the meantime, I'll see you in the next video, which I'm sure you'll find interesting.